talk about it, man. You in there, pure warrior, pure heart, iron chin. Let's talk about it, man. How do you feel? HBO, big stage. How was it, man?
I feel great. I think I did my part, as in, you know, doing what I had to do performance-wise. You know, Verdejo's an undefeated fighter, ex-Olympian, you know. That just says everything. He has way much more experience than me. I only had 40-some amateur fights. He probably had 150, 200. So, you know, we went up there with a good quality opponent. We came up short.
Was the overwhelming Puerto Rican presence in there, did that have any effect on you in the ring, or are you just there with your tunnel vision? Are you completely focused?
Not so much of a tunnel vision, but I use that to motivate me. You know, it was just all motivation. I as soon as I walked out, people talking this, people talking that, but I use it as motivation.
How would you rank his power?
Honestly, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'll give it like a 6. It wasn't much of the power that he dropped me with. It was just that he caught me real quick, and I didn't see it. It was just a flash knockout. As you can see, I got up real quick. I wasn't stunned or anything, so it was just more of a quick pop, and he caught me.
What would you want people to know you for? Is it your warrior spirit, your iron chin? What do you want the casual fans who may start to know you now because of this HBO fight with Felix Verdejo, for them to be your thing you do?
Exactly that, you know. I'm not a quitter. I'm a warrior. I get dropped, I'm gonna come back up and keep fighting, you know. You gotta leave me laid down on the floor for me to lose or quit. And as you saw, it didn't happen this fight. He dropped me twice, but got back
up. I mean, hey man, you gotta have a lot of heart. You share a nickname with Brandon Rios, and that's another guy that's a straight warrior with a lot of heart, you know? So y'all here in New York City, tomorrow's the parade. I know you said you wanted to ruin the festivities, man. You might as well join in. Are you gonna have some fun with the New York City Puerto Ricans?
You know what? If we're in town, we'll probably stop by. You know, just say what's up and that's it. But I have nothing against Puerto Ricans. They're cool. Felix Verdejo, real humble guy, real nice. You know, it kind of sucked actually fighting him. I feel like we became homeboys.
Yeah.
When I met him up in Puerto Rico, so. But you know, it's part of the game, and we had to do it.
You know, at the weigh-in, you had a lot of photographers mad, man. You didn't want to take off the snapback. You were styling on them, man. You was on the weight there, you know, and you was like, what am I going to take this off for? It's because you was repping the Spurs right there, repping San Antonio.
That's exactly what it was, and they're telling me to take it off. Why, man? Why? Why am I going to take off my hat? I wasn't doing anything.
Texas, that's why.
So, you know, I kept it on. What are they going to do?
Tell the fans something we don't know about you. Something personal. A celebrity crush. Anything. What don't we know about you?
Shit, celebrity crush. Jennifer Aniston. I love her.
All right.
Oh, there you go. God, I love her.
There you go. You got friends on Netflix, man. You can't lose. Right there, man. Ande Emilio, Ivan Bam Bam. You already know what time it is. ESNEWS reporting, baby.